This is a Ryzen ITX B350 motherboard from Gigabyte. It isn't the first ever in this form factor, but it is one of the best you can currently buy, despite its odd quirks. We're going to cover all of that in this video, including overclockability, feature sets, and pricing. I'd first like to address motherboard features. Most of the stuff you can just read online. I say that in pretty much every motherboard review video at this point, but there are a few strange locations, a few placements that might have you scratching your head. Starting first with the rear I/O, this is pretty much typical stuff. HDMI display ports for AMD APUs, 7.1 surround sound but no optical support, 6 USB 3.1 ports, two of which are type A, and a single RJ45 port. Oh, and a PS2 port, though if you're still using this in 2017, I don't know. A huge selling point of this motherboard though, onboard Wi-Fi, that's a huge plus, especially in this form factor. Now on to the internals. This board layout is a bit unorthodox. Sure, the CPU socket is centered, but RAM slots are off to the far right, where the 24-pin and SATA usually are. Gigabyte's done this to make room for stock AMD coolers, which can be a bit bulky. See, the slots occupy the far right side of the board, so everything that would normally go here on a typical motherboard, including 24-pin SATA, like I said, that's all been moved up here. Most coolers fit pretty snug, but it's no different on Intel's side with its squared off layout. The typical format had to be altered, but Gigabyte's done a fair job. On account of the new socket, a few extra compromises had to be made, more so than what I mentioned in this video right here. You'll always lose a few features, but in this case, a few mandatory features had to be moved to strange new places on the board. Take this 24-pin for example. It's all the way at the top of the board, so you'll have to route your cable through the top of your case, not the right side where it usually is routed. And here's the 8-pin EPS dock, way down here behind the MOSFET heatsink. Super strange indeed. These locations could drive you crazy. The USB 3.0 is also up top, as is the front I/O dock and all SATA ports. Potentially a cable management nightmare, depending on which case you choose. Nonetheless, I cannot go without stating these downfalls in this review. Oh, and I suppose also having only two fan hubs is pretty negative. You'll have to find a fan hub, without a doubt, if you plan on using a case like the NZXT Manta. But don't worry, this is where the quirkiness stops. Everything else about this board is what you might expect from Gigabyte by this point. Those are positives. For one, overclocking is consistent and actually decent for a board of this size, and also considering the fact that it's only a B350 chip and not the X370 Supreme overclocker chipset. I hit the exact same overclocks with both my 1600 and 1700X Ryzen CPUs, 3.9 GHz apiece, that I hit with the Aorus X370 board. As far as I'm concerned, the systems are stable at these frequencies, even under heavy load in IDA64. My RAM frequency is still a bit finicky though. I can't pass 2400 MHz despite BIOS updates, though I'd point to the youth of this platform as the cause, since most manufacturers are still dealing with these repercussions. Newegg's even pretty blunt about this on their website. Something I did not expect with the AB350N was its full-on RGB support, not only from just the hardware standpoint, you have LEDs kind of lining the full right side of this board, but also peripherally. The Rgb Fusion software gives users a variety of color presets, which can be mixed with different pulses and cycling effects. It's a nice touch for a board that won't break the bank. Another pleasant surprise was the RGBW LED header near the PCIe slot, good for extended light strips with a dedicated white LED, hence the fifth pin. This board also supports a single M.2 slot around the back, which is always nice on an ITX board, and onboard Bluetooth 4.1 for wireless device connectivity. Now, many of you are asking for BIOS UEFI tours and motherboard review videos, so here you go. This is Gigabyte's signature BIOS UI, pretty consistent across both Intel and AMD platforms at this point in time. You find all of your overclock settings here on the far left page. You also have a fan control software built into the BIOS so that you can kind of visually manipulate your fan curves. And as mentioned earlier, you'll also find the Rgb Fusion app where you can manipulate motherboard colors and cycling effects. The simplicity here is key, and I'm glad Gigabyte hasn't changed too much with this particular UEFI. It's very easy through which to navigate, and it's not buggy at all. I haven't had a single crash since I've started testing this board. Look, I know it has some quirks, and I don't know how much of that Gigabyte could really control, given the youth of the platform and the form factor. This is one of the first on the market, by the way, but it has the typical Gigabyte flair. It has the beauty, the looks. It has the RGB integration, it has the steel-reinforced PCIe slot down below, it has onboard Wi-Fi, you get that out of the box. It's a nice board. It just has a few quirks that are gonna be difficult to get around for some, depending on your case choice, like I said, but I still recommend it. Maybe not for all ITX builds. It would look pretty weird in an NZXT Manta due to its strange I.O. placement, but it'd work nicely in something like a Fractal Node 202, a true small form factor build. The AB350N is also a decent price, just over $100, which isn't an extraordinary figure given the form factor. Smaller PCs tend to cost a bit more, especially when it comes to power supply, so having a board at this price, with all the features that Gigabyte's included, is very nice. So if you're in the market for a small form factor Ryzen PC build, as most budget-conscious consumers are and should be, don't look any further than this motherboard right here. Just have a plan for dealing with these weird power and peripheral placements as well as the sheer lack of fan hubs. With the Gigabyte AB350N gaming Wi-Fi, the pros definitely outweigh the cons. As usual, you can find this product linked in the video description. It's tied to my Amazon affiliate account, gives me a small kickback, lets me make more videos like this one. I do appreciate it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, thumbs down for the opposite. Click the subscribe button if you haven't already, and I will catch you in the next video. This is Science Studio. Thanks for learning with us.